to another edition of the Verde Valley Experience. I'm your host, Jennifer Cohen. Another great show for you today. Wow. From September 16th to September 20th, there are so many things to see and do here in the Verde Valley. So I want you to get your calendars, pen and paper. You're going to make a list. Okay, here's what you need. You're going to need your dancing shoes. You're going to need your camping equipment, open hearts for our teens and our veterans, and also your kilt. Yep, that's right. You're going to need a kilt. On September 20th, you're invited to immerse yourself in the sights and sounds and tastes of Celtic heritage. Dorothy O'Brien and John Good from the Sedona Celtic Heritage Festival will be here in the studio to share all the information about this really fun annual event. Sky Biasetti, operations manager from U.S. Vets in Prescott, will be here to discuss Arizona Stand Down's amazing program that benefits homeless veterans. They're having an event on September 16th and 17th. Rachel Murdoch, the parks and recreation manager, will be here to talk about the community camp out, which is happening at Sunset Park September 19th through the 20th. Elaine Bremner from the Verde Valley Senior Center will be here to tell us about the USO style dance and soup kitchen that's going to be happening at the Verde Valley Senior Center, and that's coming up on September 20th. And we'll make a visit to the newly opened Cottonwood Teen Center that's on Mingus in the old firehouse, and we'll talk to President Alan Marks. And he's going to tell us a little bit and show us around this wonderful safe place with lots of fun activities for our great local teens. We want to keep them safe. And we'll close out our show today with a very special musical treat in honor of the upcoming Celtic Harvest Fest. Irish balladeer Carl Jones will be live in the studio today. He'll be delighting us with his showmanship and his talent. So got your pen, got your paper, ready to write it down. Sit down, hold on, because here we go. My first guest today is Elaine Bremner, the executive director of the Verde Valley Senior Center. Elaine, it's so nice to see you. Thank you for being here.
Well, thank you, Jennifer. I really appreciate the opportunity to be able to put out information, you know, about the Senior Center.
Absolutely. Yes. And what a beautiful Senior Center it is. If you haven't been there, I've been there for a couple of events. Beautiful place to have events. It's so gorgeous and the food is always so good.
Well, thank you. Yes, it is. And do you know, I have a new chef. He started this week.
Oh.
And his name is Arthur Patrick. Mm-hmm. And he's very famous in these parts for his special soups, specialty soups, etc. But he knows how to cook. He's just quite brilliant, and I'm just happy as a lark to have him as one of our team.
I bet.
Yes.
Well, that's wonderful.
If he weren't cooking so hard, you know, I'd have had him here today.
Oh.
But we'll save him for the next time around.
And the next time we'll have an in-studio demonstration, he'll make one of his special soups.
That's right.
Who doesn't like soup?
This is true. And talking about soup,
mm-hmm.
you know, the USO dance on September 20th, and unfortunately, it's on the same day as my Celtic buddies out there, you know, and that will offer half a dozen different soups.
Wow.
By different restaurateurs.
Mm-hmm.
Brandy, who used to have a restaurant in town,
right.
still likes to make her baked potato cheese soup.
Mm.
And she's going to be doing that, even though she doesn't have the restaurant anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Denny's is also providing a soup, and I'm going to put my glasses on because the print became rather small at that point. Actually, Denny's is making a wonderful clam chowder. I don't know if you've tried their clam chowder, but it's very good. And then Mary at Girona Cafe, a pumpkin soup, which is one of her specialties.
Oh.
And then Nate's Cowboy Cafe will be offering a green chili potato soup.
Mm.
And Sizzler's Steak and Seafood restaurant is going to be offering a broccoli cheese soup.
Wow.
And I made a mistake. Brandy is also famous for chicken noodle soup, and that's what she's offering.
Oh.
So, and then the Senior Center, our own chef, Arthur, will be introducing one of his surprise soups, and it's all bound to be good. So there's half a dozen soups to choose from.
That's great. My mother used to make surprise soup.
Oh, yeah, I bet she does.
Now I make surprises. It's called throwing leftovers in a pot.
That's always
a lot
good.
Better.
That makes it better.
That's true. What's this one called?
Yes.
Oh, surprise.
Yes.
Guess what's in it? But I know it'll be so much better than
as
that.
As long as they didn't put tripe in it, I was all right.
Oh, yeah. No way.
But the other wonderful thing that's going to happen that night is we have music by Charlie Allen and the Happy Nights Band.
Aww.
These are so talented. These people are so talented. And Charlie Allen, I mean, she looks like a teenager and still has that wonderful voice. And so you have the opportunity to swing to music of the 30s and 40s.
Oh,
so
wonderful.
Stepping back into yesteryear and The other good thing is you can wear your uniform if you're in the military, serving this country or any other country. Wear your uniform. That's if you can still fit into it. It's always the challenge, isn't it? Yeah. So that's the USO dance information on Saturday, September 20th, and that's from 6 to 9 p.m.
From 6 to 9. That's great at the Verde Valley Senior Center.
And this is a fundraiser that benefits our home delivered meals program. Admission is $15 per person.
Absolutely, and well worth supporting the Meals on Wheels program. That's a really great program that you guys run.
We serve many people throughout the Verde Valley, and if you'd like me to expand on that at this point, I shall. Our service delivery area includes Jerome, Clarkdale, Cottonwood, Cornville, Lake Montezuma and the Rimrock areas.
Wow.
Middle Verde, which is 5 miles back this side of the freeway, Camp Verde, and then Verde Lakes, which is 5 miles the other side of the freeway,
you know,
and all of the Verde Village areas. So there are a lot of people receiving this wonderful service, and we are such a lifeline to them.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
And the meals are all prepared at the Verde Valley Senior Center, located in Cottonwood, 500 East Cherry Street, and they're delivered by our wonderful heart and soul volunteers. It takes a very special person to commit, you know, that 1.5 hours, 1 day a week, and we're always looking for volunteers.
Yeah,
just like all the other nonprofits in town.
Absolutely.
You know, so if you can spare 1.5 hours, 1 day a week,
sure. Look, and you have a vehicle.
Yes, and have a vehicle. You know, you'll meet the nicest people.
Oh, I
but
bet.
But they're the most deserving people, in looking forward to a friendly smile and a lovely, hot, nutritious meal.
Oh, how great! I know that is a wonderful program. I've known people who have been involved on both sides of that program, and it's such a wonderful thing. And of course, the USO style dance and soup kitchen is all in support of that. So your $15 admission will go to help the Meals on Wheels program. Again, there's going to be so much great food there, all those wonderful soups, and the dancing to the the old music.
And dessert,
that's just too much fun. Oh, and dessert. Well,
and
you had me at soup, and now you say dessert.
Well, you can't have soup without having dessert. Makes you dance a little better. You get the sugar rush.
You have a very good point. And that's all happening Saturday, September 20th, from 6 until 9 at the gorgeous Verde Valley Senior Center. That's going to be way too much fun. I will see you there, won't I?
Yes, I'm sure you will.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Put your dancing shoes on.
Absolutely.
Do you swing dance?
Actually, yes, I like to rock and roll, but I'm a little slow right now. I have a little back problem, but I'm an old-time waltzer more than anything.
Wow.
Yes.
Well, we'll be out there seeing you stretch your stuff,
I hope
sure.
So.
That's really great.
Well,
Elaine, if they want to volunteer to help out with the Meals on Wheels program, who should they contact?
Yes, just call 928-634-5450. Just contact anyone that answers the phone at the Verde Valley Senior Center. Mm-hmm. Should be able to assist with that. We have a website. It's verdevalleyseniorcenter.org. You know, www. You know, and you could contact us via the website.
Very good.
Via email, which is seniorcenter@verdenet.com.
Nice.
It's a lot to remember. Just call 634-5450.
Oh, great.
Yes.
Elaine Bremner, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you for all the work you're doing over there at the Senior Center and your lovely smile.
Well, thank you very much.
I look forward to seeing you dancing Saturday, September 20th.
Well, thank you.
See you there.
Thank
and we'll
you
be
very
right
much.
Back, so don't go away.
All right.
Hi. I'm Jacqueline. There are now more registered voters in Arizona who say that they are independent than those who claim a particular party. If that's you, independents can vote in the primary elections after they select a party ballot. You fill it out and mail it back. If you vote at your polling place on election day, they will ask which ballot you'd like. Even though you're not a registered party member, your right to vote is protected and your vote will count.
A message from the League of Women Voters of Arizona.
When the city lights fade, our lights get brighter. When your night needs life, ours comes alive. When you want to do something different, we say, come out and play. Come experience the new Mountain Springs Buffet. All you can eat starting at just $7.
The Cliff Castle Casino Hotel, voted number one casino in Arizona 15 years in a row. So I just moved in with this family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
And welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. I'm here now with Dorothy O'Brien, Festival Director for the Celtic Harvest Fest, and John Good, the Artistic Director for the Celtic Harvest Festival, and also Welsh Master of Music. I love that title.
Oh, yes, yeah, nice. It's not true, of course. But...
Oh, come now. It has to be. It's all over the internet.
Oh, yes, of course it's true. Yeah.
Thank you guys so much for being here.
Thanks for having
the
us.
The Celtic Harvest Festival is always so much fun, just between the folks that come and the music and the food. It's just such a great presentation. You have a new venue this year.
We do. This year, I'm happy to tell you, we're at the Verde Valley School. Mm-hmm. Beautiful Morris Field.
Yeah.
Beautiful, stunning views. The pictures, just the experience of being in that bowl of cathedral and down by the creek. It's gorgeous.
Right.
Beautiful, beautiful setting. And the school, of course, you know, they've always wanted to have a signature event like this since Jazz on the Rocks or the Jackson Brown concert. So I think we found our forever home.
Oh, good. Well,
and we're looking forward to it.
Great. Yeah. And the festival is September 20th. It starts at 9:30 in the morning, and it goes until 5:30 in the afternoon at the Verde Valley School, which is in the village of Oak Creek on Verde Valley School Road, right there in the gorgeous Red Rocks.
You
nice
bet.
Big green field. That's a huge space, and I know you're going to fill it. Tell me, what's going to be happening at the Celtic Fest?
Well, we've got all kinds of, every kind of culture that's associated with the Celtic people, from pipers and musicians and a whole stage devoted to storytelling.
Wow.
Don't miss it.
Yes.
The sheepdog demos, we have experts there with their dogs to demonstrate. They've actually collaborated with the school with some ducks.
Ducks.
Yes, so the school is raising ducks.
And the sheep ducks.
And sheep ducks, yes.
Yeah. Sheep ducks.
And it's really a nice, again, it's a very large community event.
Yeah.
So you this year, for the first time too, in addition to all the cultural music, dance, pipe stories, we're welcoming the Snap Fitness inaugural Highland Games.
The Highland Games.
Yes, yes. Very exciting.
That is very exciting.
Yeah. So.
And tell me, you've got the Scottish American Military Society will be raising your colors this year.
Yeah. We love to include all the Celtic nations. Mm-hmm. And many, many of our veterans belong to some of these groups that really celebrate their culture, their history, their family history. So it's a great place. Very stirring. Don't miss the presentation of colors at 9:30.
Of course, the pipe band. It'll be there, the Glendale Pipe Band, and traditionally they march into war. They're called war pipes.
They are
Scottish pipes. So, we'll have those type of bagpipes, and also I'll have my Welsh pipes here. These are
We're
in a revival state here. As you can see, there's all kinds of animals involved. This is Cullinan wood. This is Hollywood. This is I think it's supposed to be a bull.
Sure.
And some poor unfortunate gave up its skin for that.
Sure. Camel, perhaps?
Maybe.
Oh, well.
Are there any camels in Wales?
No! I thought they had camels everywhere. So I think I'm going to take a guess. The music is your favorite part of the festival.
Oh, yes. I love storytelling, and my mother always called me a romancer. I'm not quite sure what she meant by that, but yes, we're going to have a Scottish piper and whistle player, Davy Brewer. He was absolutely incredible, and also with him is going to be Rebecca Lomninke, and she's the youngest fiddle player and also the only American fiddle player that's ever won the Scottish Glenfiddich Championship.
Whoa.
She's special.
Yeah.
Of course, Carl Jones will be here. We've got an Irishman. I'll be on the Welsh side, and there'll be all kinds of pipers and everything everywhere else, and it'll be a great day out.
Oh, I bet. And it's fun for the whole family, too, adults and children involved. So to get into the festival, adults are 15. Teens are only $5, and children under the age of 11 are free with an adult.
Fairy Village.
Yes.
Fairy Village for the children.
Fairy Village.
Yes.
Get out.
No, the Sedona Charter School is creating a whole fairy village with maypoles and everything.
Oh.
Don't miss it.
Well, that's great. Mm-hmm. So there's something for everyone. And of course, we mentioned there's food. There's going to be all kinds of good food, but there's also going to be spirits and libations this year, too.
John. An important feature of the Celtic Festival, of course.
Yes, of course. There's going to be all kinds of mead, single malt scotch, beer, wine. Woohoo!
Fun.
That'll be a lot of fun.
Everybody will relax in the gorgeous setting.
Yes, and then you'll start dancing.
And everybody starts dancing. We'll hopefully get some of the grandmothers up as well. They seem to get up for this type of dancing.
It's fun.
You can't help yourself, of course.
No.
Everyone gets on the dance floor.
Yeah.
It's really fun. And the vendors. We have some really fun vendors. One vendor's coming. They make wooden games and puzzles.
Oh.
Another, just beautiful stuff coming. So
that's
kilts,
great.
Of course, swords
you
and
need
knives.
A new one?
And
yeah, I wore mine out years ago. I should go get a new one. But there's all kinds of interesting souvenirs and handmade crafts and all sorts of Celtic associated with things and jewelry and just wonderful things to peruse if you like to be on the shopping side of things. You can be on the eating side of things. There's a craft section for the little kids. There's a sheepdog demonstrations with the ducks.
Yes.
That's going to be a scream.
Also, festival. I can't call him a magician, but he actually is Thomas Bopp, the man who discovered the comet. He comes and talks to people and will give a demonstration of some of his photographs and from the space. And just an incredible man to talk to if you have any interest in that. I was going to say magician, but you can't call him.
No, he'll answer all your cosmic questions.
All the cosmic questions will be answered.
I have some very deep cosmic questions.
He has the answers.
Thomas Bopp, wow.
Thomas Bopp will be there himself.
That's exciting.
Dr. Thomas.
He's our festival astronomer.
Very approachable and very, very knowledgeable.
So. That is amazing. And you guys have a great website, CelticHarvestFestival.com. You can check it out. There's pictures on there. There's information. There's times. There's the price list and the breakdown on the tickets and all kinds of good stuff you can go ahead and see there. This is just such a wonderful, anything having to do with history and heritage is always so much fun to have a festival about. And it's a huge, all-encompassing festival with all the different traditional ways of doing things. And the sports ought to be really, look like some
They're
very interesting sports, throwing of odd little heavy things and
and cabers and like telephone poles and rocks.
Yeah. Oh, light things. No big deal. Just little things.
Things like
but
that.
But they're all tied to the culture. They are.
Yes. Telephone pole throwing.
Absolutely. Imagine a farm.
You don't want to mess with people who throw telephone poles.
No.
Imagine a farm and you have to move stuff like this and all the farm hands get very competitive and 100 years later you're throwing telephone poles. But started centuries ago.
That's amazing. Yeah. I think I have to go just to see a human throw a
You're
going to
have
pole.
Fun.
I have never seen that. That's unbelievable.
The languages will be represented. I'm a Welsh speaker. I speak Gymraeg and I think we'll have some Irish and hopefully some Scottish there as well. So just smatterings and explanations will be forthcoming.
Wow.
So, and the storytelling, that is really something that gets left out of a lot of festivals. Mm-hmm. And that's really heritage. One of the only things I ever regret is I didn't ask my grandfather to tell me more stories when I was young.
Because
he'd been all over the world.
And it all starts in the schools, John.
Yeah,
our artists will all be in the schools.
Yeah, going to the schools.
The week before to bring these programs and these stories and music to our school children.
That's great. So. Thank you guys for putting on such a wonderful festival.
Thank you.
So the Celtic Harvest Festival is September 20th from 9:30 a.m. till 5:30 p.m. at the Verde Valley School, which is in Via Voce, the village of Oak Creek on Verde Valley School Road. Let's go ahead and see you there, but don't go away because we'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Sarina. It's almost election time again. Voting is a very important part of making a democracy work. Like many of you, I've signed up to receive an early ballot by mail each election. But because it comes weeks before the election, it's easy to just put it aside and forget it.
But keep it handy as you learn about the candidates and issues. When you're done voting, the rest is simple. Just put the ballot in the white envelope and sign it. Then put that envelope in the larger yellow envelope.
Just seal it and drop it in any mailbox.
A message from the League of Women Voters of Arizona.
When the city lights fade, our lights get brighter. When your night needs life, ours comes alive. When you want to do something different, we say, come out and play. Come experience the new Mountain Springs Buffet. All you can eat starting at just $7.
The Cliff Castle Casino Hotel, voted number one casino in Arizona 15 years in a row.
Good one, son.
Last summer, my new dad took me on vacation. First, we went deep sea fishing.
Wow! I'm so proud of you, son.
And then we went on Thunder Shark. That was awesome! Let's go again! 3 times. I gotta say, it was pretty cool.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of kids in foster care will take you just as you are.
Oh, not again.
Welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. I'm here now with Skye Biasetti. She is the operations manager for U.S. Vets out of Prescott. Thank you so much for being here, Skye.
Thanks for having me.
And thank you for the work that you do with U.S. Vets. It's a really worthwhile program, and you've been there a while now.
I am going on 8 years.
Yeah.
8 years, yeah. It's a great organization. Love working with them.
I bet. Now, you're going to talk to us about the Arizona Stand Down event, which is from September 16th all the way through to the 17th. But first, can we get a little backstory? Can you tell us a little bit about what U.S. Vets does, and then we'll go into Arizona
Absolutely.
Stand Down?
Absolutely. U.S. Vets is a national organization. We're actually the largest nonprofit provider for homeless veteran services across the country. Mm-hmm. We have 12 sites across the country. And we provide transitional housing, permanent housing, supportive services for veterans and their families, along with many other programs. Anything we can do to get them out of homelessness.
Right, yes. Your job is to give them the tools that they need to get past that point in their lives and get on to living good lives.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. Transition. Our mission is the successful transition of military veterans and their family through the provision of housing, counseling, and comprehensive support.
That's great. Yeah. Thank you for the work you do. Now, tell us a little bit about Arizona Stand Down. First of all, explain Stand Down to me again.
Well, Stand Down was actually originated as a grassroots idea in San Diego. My understanding, I may not be verbatim, but my understanding is that stand down in the military terms was when the individual soldiers, they get a reprieve from battle. Mm-hmm. They'd be able to go get a shower, get a hot meal, get a moment of really rest. Mm-hmm. And stand down was created very similar to that in order to give them a rest and a reprieve from being homeless. And ideally, to give them housing, you know, to really work on getting them into housing first and then wrapping supportive services around them in order for them to, like you said, grab the have the tools to remain in housing and be successfully transitioned into the community.
Right. Sure. Now, you guys are having an event September 16th all the way through. It's an overnight
yes.
event until the 17th at Tim's Toyota Center in Prescott.
Prescott Valley, yes.
Yeah.
We have the event. We try to bring in all the supportive service providers, such as motor vehicle department, mm-hmm. to maybe help them get their ID or get a license back. We have attorneys that work pro bono to try to help address legal barriers to housing and employment. Mm-hmm. We have Department of Economic Security, Social Security. I mean, basically every supportive service that can really break down barriers mm-hmm. to housing and employment so that they can truly get back into the community. In addition to that, there's also for those that either choose not to go into housing or for whatever reason can't get into housing, we want to make sure we know winter's around the corner. We don't
yeah.
want anybody out there during winter, but if for whatever reason they are, we want to make sure they have supplies to be able to get through that winter.
All right.
So we give cold weather gear to unsheltered homeless. We give hygiene kits. We provide food the entire time, and we get them hooked up to the services to end the homeless cycle.
Wow. That's amazing. That sounds like a lot of work. You guys run on volunteerism mostly, huh?
Absolutely. We have a great community all over northern Arizona, which is U.S. Vets coverage area. And volunteers is the only thing that makes anything happen.
Sure.
So we are always looking for volunteers to help man the event, whether it be helping, you know, serving food, picking up trash, even down to, you know, breaking down and setting up for the event itself.
Right. It sounds like there's a lot to be broken down and set up. But Tim Soyota Center, if you haven't been there, is huge.
Yes.
You can fit a lot of stuff in there.
Yes. And they've been amazing. They help us with all the tables and chairs. A lot of the setup they actually help us with. And it's just more moving things around to be the way we need it to be for the event. But volunteers is what makes it go, absolutely.
Sure. And if somebody's interested in volunteering for this particular event for Arizona Stand Down, or maybe make a further effort to it, what should they do? Who should they contact?
They can contact myself, or they can actually go right online and do it directly at www.arizonastanddown.org. Okay. Arizona is spelled out. Mm-hmm. And or they could contact me at 928-583-7679.
Yeah, that definitely sounds like something you could use some help with.
Absolutely.
Sure.
And if there's any service providers that feel they may have something that they can help these veterans break down barriers to employment, they're welcome to call me as well.
Right. Wow. That's really great. Yeah. If you've got a special talent or service, perhaps, that could help a homeless vet, you know, please volunteer your efforts with the Arizona Stand Down. Now, tell me a little bit about the Alliance. There's also an Alliance.
Yes. We have been the Prescott Stand Down, Maricopa Stand Down, and Tucson Stand Downs, I wouldn't say is the biggest or anything, but they are the most established. Mm-hmm. And over the years, we've noticed, you know, Prescott may have one thing but not another, but Maricopa has that and Prescott doesn't. The idea of the Stand Down was to really provide a guidance for all stand downs across the state.
Right.
In order to make sure resources get spread to where they're really needed.
Mm-hmm.
And be able to support each other. So over the past couple years, we've been creating the Stand Down Alliance, which the website I mentioned before is the main website for that.
Sure.
Where individuals can either volunteer, donate time or money. It all goes to one pot.
Uh-huh.
Where it's able to go where it's needed.
Excellent.
It also gives us the opportunity to go to bigger organizations. Mm-hmm. And say, you know, in the past we've had three organizations come to you to support different stand downs across the
right.
state, but here we're going to throw 10 stand downs across the state in these areas with these specific needs to homeless veterans.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what we need help with to get there.
That's great. How wonderfully organized that is. Thank you for all the work you do, Sky.
It's awesome.
That is a lot. Sky Biasetti, she is the operations manager from U.S. Vets in Prescott, and we've been talking about the Arizona Stand Down event that's going to happen September 16th through the 17th at Tim's Toyota Center in Prescott Valley. You can check them out, arizonastanddown.org. And we'll be right back.
Same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
When the city lights fade, our lights get brighter. When your night needs life, ours comes alive. When you want to do something different, we say, come out and play. Come experience the new Mountain Springs Buffet. All you can eat starting at just $7.
Cliff Castle Casino Hotel, voted number one casino in Arizona 15 years in a row.
All And welcome back. I'm here now with Rachel Murdoch. She is the Parks and Recreation Manager, and she's here to talk about the Community Camp Out, which is going to be happening at Sunset Park in Sedona on September 19th all the way through the morning of the 20th. Now, that is a lot of fun. Camping in the city. Of course, it's not really the city because it's a beautiful park. If you haven't been to Sunset Park in Sedona, it's just up Sunset Road, and it's quite lovely.
Right. We like it.
Yeah. It's a wonderful place for camping. Beautiful, lush grass. How did you guys come up with this idea?
Oh, wow. It was a while ago now. I'm a parent, so I generally try to think of ideas that would be fun to take my own kids to. What would I put forth the effort to do with them? Mm-hmm. And this is one of those ideas. And it's really unique because there's so many families who've never camped on their own.
Yeah.
And they show up and they're like, what's s'mores? We've never done that.
They don't know what s'mores are.
I know. I'm like, you're an adult. What did you do when you were a kid? So it's a neat experience. It gives them that opportunity without having to have all the equipment go out into the scary wild on their own.
Or the hassle of driving somewhere and finding a camping spot. And setting up the tent is fun. And what I love about this is if you have a tent, great. It's $15 to participate. If you don't have a tent, you can be provided a tent
$35. $35 and we'll set it up for you. So bring your toothbrush and your pillow.
Gosh, it's worth $35. To have you set up a tent for me. Because that's part of the fun.
Right. For some people.
Yes, for some people.
Yeah.
Right. Yes, absolutely. But camping is such a wonderful experience for children. It's really something that they should all do. Mm-hmm. And a lot of kids who tend to play a lot of video games and hang out and watch TV, they really need to be shown what it's like to be outside in the evening time, especially when most of them may be inside having a bath and going to bed.
Right.
This gets an excuse to be outside after dark.
It is. And it's very popular, too, because mentioning being outside, we always have the astronomy club there.
Oh, right.
And so the adults and the kids love looking through the telescopes. And Sedona is a great place to be able to do that with our dark skies.
Yes.
There's a lot of stars to look at. And then we also have special groups come in and do different lectures, talk about different things. And we have the Forest Service coming this time.
Right.
So they're going to talk about hiking preparedness, leave no trace behind. Sure. We have different crafts or activities we do for the kids.
Yeah.
So it's pretty well-rounded.
There's a lot going on. Absolutely. And food is provided. May not have mentioned that. Food is provided. Of course, you have dinner, and then you're going to have dessert, which is s'mores, which is fabulous. There is a breakfast the next day, all provided. There's a wonderful early morning hike that'll be led by the Forest Service folks. J.D. Maddie will be there to participate in astronomy, which will be gorgeous this time of year to look into the sky, and that will already be there. Everything will be there that you need. Just need
it
to
is.
Bring yourselves.
It is. That's why I said bring your toothbrush and your pillow, and pretty much everything else is provided. Sunset Park is one of our best parks for playgrounds, and it has our brand new splash park there.
Yes.
So the kids are busy long after. We have to call them over. It's time to grill your hot dog because they're just running around playing.
Yeah.
And when it gets dark, we provide glow-in-the-dark necklaces so you can still find your kids, which is handy.
That's true.
So
you are a mom. You know.
That's right. I've got a lot of tricks up my sleeve. So it is very busy. And before you know it, you know, it's time to go to bed. And then there's more in the morning.
Right. Wow. Mm-hmm. That is really amazing. And there's also going to be music.
That's right.
We're going to have a local musician on
site. We started that last year. Was our first time having singing around the campfire.
Oh.
And we didn't know if people would be uncomfortable. But you know what? If they enjoy participating, they do. And if they don't, then they can just hear it. And, you know, the musician will be out there strumming their guitar. And they're very energetic, getting people involved. So I think it was a neat addition. People like it.
Absolutely. What's a campfire without campfire songs and singing?
Mm-hmm.
And that's just great. And a campfire, a real campfire.
Right.
You guys will be having.
Mm-hmm.
Like real roasted s'mores and hot
yes.
dogs.
Yes. And we have it all set up ahead of time. So people have to take turns, but it doesn't seem to be a problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we've got like 14 skewers and they go around, take their turn, come over, eat, pass it on. I think it actually makes it more community that they're sharing and taking turns.
Yeah. Do you have a limit as to how many campers?
We've said we wouldn't hold more than 30 tents, but we don't reach that amount, so it's safe. I think our best attendance was 19 or 20 tents.
Nice.
So we have room to grow.
Uh-huh.
And so people should come out and try it for a first time.
Right. And you guys have a registration deadline,
yes.
which is September 17th.
Yes. We need to know how many are coming so we know how much food to make sure we have.
Right, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And to reserve a spot, you guys got to give them a call at 282-7098. Give them a call over there at the rec center and let them know you're coming so that they have food.
That's right. That's right.
That's amazing. You don't have to pack food. I mean, part of the problem with camping is what are we going to take for food? Packing the cooler, schlepping all that stuff.
And your then, barbecue of course, grill.
Hiking it all out into the middle of nowhere.
That's
and then you
right.
got critters. But with,
schlepping it.
Yes.
Right. When the police department drives through at night, people mm-hmm. feel safe. Because it's in the park, we have bollards that light up the sidewalks to get you to the restroom.
That's right.
Always open.
Real restroom.
Yes. So it really just is very convenient. Mm-hmm. So it is good if you're first time to try it, but it's good if you're seasoned and you don't want to have to take everything.
Yeah, absolutely. Have mm-hmm. to deal with all that and have a real, I don't know about you, but I like a real bathroom. Peeing in the woods is good
no.
for bears.
It's a no-go.
No. Too cool. And with any luck, the coyotes will start howling.
That would be neat.
Way too much fun.
If not, you'll hear the dogs from the Humane Society.
They could
They're
start
nearby.
Too. Yes, yes, absolutely. Yeah. Sunset Park is a really, really nice place to have it. The views are wonderful. Mm-hmm. It's elevated. It's got that beautiful lawn. And, of course, you have the facilities there and the
right.
playground. So the kids can get out of your hair if you want to sit around and chat.
That's
the kids
right.
kids will play the playground and the splash park. Make sure they bring their bathing suits.
Yes.
Because the splash park, if you haven't been there, is so cool. Thank you guys for putting in the splash park.
Yeah, people have been really great. Happy with it.
Yeah. Sunset Park was great anyway, and now mm-hmm. it's even better. And to do this camp out, which is going to be September 19th, so you're going to show up at 5 p.m. You're going to do your little setup thing and hang out, and then you guys are going to have dinner.
That's
and
right.
And then party all night.
Yeah right. Music, astronomy, mm-hmm. lectures, food,
yep.
chocolate.
Oh, chocolate.
So
great, magic word.
We've got it all covered.
And then there's breakfast in the morning, followed by a hike, which is going to have the Forest Service people live by. It's just going to be a wonderful evening for the whole family. So I encourage you guys to get involved. Contact the Parks and Rec Center. Reserve your space. I want to go. I think that's going to be so
well,
much fun.
Well, you'd have fun.
I would. I love camp. Rachel, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
And thank you guys so much for putting on the community camp out. That's
okay.
a wonderful thing for everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. And we'll be right back with more Verde Valley Experience, so don't go away.
Traditional light bulbs actually generate 9 times more heat than light. Let's switch to Energy Star light bulbs and stop burning through cash. Saving energy saves you money.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
We need a claim number?
When I started taking care of Mom, I didn't realize the challenge of playing so many roles. But above all, I'm still her daughter.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving. We're here to help.
And welcome back to the Verde Valley Experience. I am now here in the brand new teen center. Yes, Cottonwood now has its very own teen center. It's now open and is so awesome. I'm here with Alan Marks. He is the chairman of the board of the teen center. Alan, thank you so much for being here.
You're quite welcome.
And thank you for doing this. I mean, what gave you the idea of putting a teen center in an old firehouse?
It's been going on for about 3 years, and we needed a building. And this happened to be sitting here in a great location, so we approached the city council, and they gave us the approval.
Wow.
And we took it from there.
That's amazing. It really is a great location. We're right here on Mingus, right across from the middle school, right by Brian Mickelson. We've got the Cottonwood Rec Center behind us. So it's a really, really super place. Now tell us, when the kids come here, what are they going to expect?
Kids come here, they're going to expect a neutral place to go, a safe place to go, and pretty much what they want. You know, we're going to have adults teaching them everything from writing, balancing a checkbook to programming computers.
Wow.
And the kids that want to relax, they got ping pong and pool, and we got a foosball table coming.
Air hockey, one of my favorites as a kid. That's pretty, and a huge screen TV. That's really amazing. And you guys are open 3 days a week, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Right.
And this is how it works. So from 3 to 6, it's grades 7th and 8th. And then from 6 until 9, it's the 9th graders to the 12th graders.
Right.
And it's free of charge.
It's now, all free.
How do you go ahead and do that? How do you make that free?
We've been doing fundraisers. We want to thank the Tilted Earth program. They just donated $10,000 to us.
Yeah.
We also, a lot of donations throughout the community. And we're looking for more donations. I mean, this is how to keep it open.
Right.
We're not asking the city for money. The county's not giving us no money. It's just all grassroots donations.
Right. And everything in here was donated. So look around. If you have anything extra in your house you don't need, you think the teens might like,
right,
they can give you a call. Right, Alan?
Give me a call. We're looking for games, Xboxes, Wiis. We're looking for volunteers especially. We need volunteers to keep the place running. We have to have adults here for the kids to be able to come. So we're looking for volunteers. We need volunteers. That's the crucial thing right now.
Yeah, definitely. And you said you're going to have little classes like on sewing or cooking.
Sewing and craft. And we're going to have people coming in and teach the kids how to do research on the internet, mm-hmm, writing resumes.
Wow.
Learning job searching skills.
Really important life skills.
Life skills.
And you said to me earlier that the main purpose of this is to keep the kids off the street and give them something safe to do.
Keep the kids off the street. Come on in, you know, this is a neutral place, safe place. You don't have to worry about the street dictating what you're going to do. It's here.
Very good. Now, what are the rules of the teen center? What are the teens going to be expected to do when they're here?
Teens are expected to respect the teen center, respect each other. We will allow no illegal drugs, gang signs, gang attire, anything. It's all going to be strictly, this is a neutral place. We don't want none of that here.
Right.
The kids are going to be expected to clean up after themselves, just like at home. They're going to, you know, we're going to have chores for them to do.
Yeah. So. Well, that's great. Get them really involved. Thank you for your community involvement in this matter.
I love doing it. You know, this is the kids' center. This is their place. They got to take care of it. It's theirs. We're the adults. They're the kids. We built this for them. We want them to enjoy it and take care of it.
Well, that's really great. It's divided up really well. You've got the, what room would we call this?
This is the activity room, rec room.
Sure, with the pool table and the air hockey and the ping pong and the big screen TV. And then in the back, you've got a computer room, which is gorgeous.
Yes.
Lovely setup with the computer room. There's a quiet room with the couches for reading, things like that. And a whole craft room, which is going to be set up with all kinds of neat things. I heard Sherry say your sewing machine was going to come in.
And, you know, we still have some things to get in here, but you know, right now we want to get it open, get the kids used to coming, and it's going to be a building process, and we'll build as we go. And you know, we've gotten it open. We promised the kids 3 years ago this would happen. It's happening.
It's truly amazing, and it was all a volunteer effort. Your construction crew was all volunteer.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that's been done in here was done by folks in the community out of the goodness of their heart, and will continue to be so. Apparently.
There's a list I couldn't begin to tell you how many people have donated to this cause in the community. So.
Yeah. I bet. That's really amazing.
The Verde Valley Computer Club, the computers, they program them, they set them up, they networked it for us. I mean, it's just awesome. So.
Yeah, that's really great. I noticed you have popcorn machines. There's a couple
popcorn,
of them.
Popcorn, yeah, we got a couple of them.
Got to have popcorn.
We sold a lot of popcorn to make this happen. So.
That's great. One of the fundraisers. Yeah. That's really fun. So the hours are really interesting. So there's after school time on Friday and Thursday, 3 o'clock if you're in 7th or 8th grade. From 3 till 6, you can come hang out after school on Thursdays and Fridays. And then on Saturdays, you're going to be open at 3 as well. And then from 6 to 9 on those three nights, it's anyone who is a high schooler. Right. So 9th through 12th.
Yeah, well, we're trying to keep them separated. You know, we don't, you know, there's a influence there, and we don't want that to happen. So we want to keep them separated. And,
sure.
And we will have some crossover, but you know, we hope not to have much.
Right, sure, I understand. So is it, anyone can show up as far as the kids go? They can show up during that little time slot?
They can show up during that time slot. Well, we will have a sign in and sign out sheet, so we will know who's coming and who's going.
Right.
So, you know, we're not, you know, the place to just take off and hide because, you know, if someone calls, we will tell them you're here.
Right. Sure. Yeah. And if anyone wants more information about how to volunteer here at the Teen Center, how to help you out, Alan, perhaps they have something they'd like to donate. Is there a phone number they should call?
Yeah, the phone number, you can get a hold of me right now at 928-821-2116. And tomorrow our other phone will be hooked up, but I don't have that number right offhand.
Very good. We'll get that from you soon. Yeah. Well, congratulations on getting the Teen Center open.
We're
Cottonwood's newest, the Verde Valley Teen Center is here, right here on Mingus across from the middle school in the old firehouse. How cool is that to be here with the firehouse bays, all changed over with cool stuff and a big screen TV. Alan Marks, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for the work you've done here.
Oh, no problem. Really I just want to thank my committee people. I mean, if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here. So.
Yeah. I mean, thank you.
We started out from small all the way up, and we've done. Yeah. They've done a
done
big
an
job.
Awesome job. Yeah. Awesome job. Thank you.
Thanks.
And we'll be right back. So don't go away.
Get out to the forest.
Let the kids connect to their roots. It's gonna be so much fun.
Yeah! Woo-hoo!
Hey, guys, wait up!
And discover the wonders of nature with your family.
These trees are the key to our way of life.
Fresh air.
What a glorious morning!
Clean water.
Woo-hoo! This is great!
And endless forest adventure.
Yeah! Let's rock this jungle!
Yo, this is untapped territory.
How amazing!
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
Separate raw meats from other foods by using different cutting boards. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
The story it unfolds. He's 11 years old, told. Sweet Donegal, 1846. Boarding coffin ships, he said. Little harvest it had fed. Over 1 million died. Watching Atlantic skies. But the boy, he did survive. And the boy became a man. Shooting Oak River Rapids in a 100-year flood. Riding Oak Creek Canyon, trees rushing past. Sun's fed in the shadow. Snow's melting fast, and it's no use. Got those old JJ blues. Old JJ ride over 5,000 miles. Right in Pump House while she drove, all his livestock and cargo. Old Indian Gardens was his new canyon home. but the wind began to blow. Blue skies then turned white with snow. Over 20 feet of water. Scream with the banshee's revenge. Driving Oak Creek Canyon. Houses are flooding fast. Sun's fed on the shadow. Snow's melting fast, and it's no use. Got those old JJ
Irish balladeer Carl Jones, everyone. That was wonderful. I was over there dancing.
Thank you. It's great to be here. Yavapai Broadcast, and yeah. Thanks for having me as a special guest.
That was great. And that was one of your originals.
That's an original composition, and they asked me to be the headliner at the St. Patrick's Day Parade in Ireland a couple of years back, because that song is about the first Irishman in Sedona, so 1876. So it's kind of a bluesy ballad fused with an Irish ballad, so
yeah,
that's what I was going for with that.
That's
song.
Great. Yeah. So you're not the first Irishman to the Oak Creek Canyon, then?
No, definitely not the first. Actually, the first Irishman was most likely Scots Irish, and
right.
he was from Donegal, and he did arrive in the Sedona, Northern Arizona area, 1876. And we have a bronze plaque commemorating him.
Really.
In Oak Creek Canyon, and that's located on 89A, mm-hmm. across from Indian Gardens Country Store. So we have this very interesting historical relationship between early Irish settlers, mm-hmm. and the Verde Valley, which is where we are and
right.
where we are filming today.
Yeah. So tell me how you got interested in the guitar. Where were you and when did you start playing?
I grew up in Ireland, mm-hmm. and I went to Our Lady's Boys School in Ballantyre, which is South Dublin, and had the opportunity to start playing guitar about the age of 7. And I actually started on a nylon string kind of classical guitar, mm-hmm. learning a more sort of a Spanish style of guitar. But there was a lot of well-known folk artists in that part of Dublin and in that area. And Christy Moore also lived in Ballantyre, where I was raised. He's a household name in Ireland, so he's one of our most famous folk singers and ballad singers. And I play several Christy Moore songs on my records and on my live repertoire.
Right.
And so,
speaking of records, how many do you have now?
I've got 4 records out there. The latest is a double album, and I've got a couple of several records on iTunes. Mm-hmm. Including one called Dublin Soul, another one called Carl Jones 1916, which is a lot of war ballads, and some musicians from the Riverdance helped me record that record.
Wow.
And then I have a best of on iTunes. So if you want just kind of a cross-section of my stuff, look for my best of Carl Jones on iTunes.
On iTunes,
yeah,
great.
CD Baby is how I distribute records, and I also have records at my live show.
Oh, great. And you're also on Facebook. It's Carl Jones,
Facebook.
Carl with a K.
And I'm the only Carl
Jones
with a K.
That's right.
In Sedona, Arizona. So I live in Oak Creek Canyon, which is, mm-hmm. Sedona, and you can find me on Facebook easily, and that way you can figure out where I'm playing.
Right, and you play a lot of places.
I do. I'm one of those people that does over 300 live performances a year, which
wow.
is an awful lot.
Yeah.
But I have a strong following and presence in Northern Arizona in the Irish American community and in the kind of Irish pubs and mm-hmm. Celtic community.
Sure.
But lately I've been playing at the Sedona Hilton, and mm-hmm. I've been playing at Cliff Castle Casino has asked me to play with them. And that's interesting because they're owned by the Native Americans. So as a person from Ireland, that's very interesting kind of history to encounter performance-wise. So there you go.
Yeah, two deeply cultural societies meeting together on music.
Yeah, and lots of interesting stories. And part of our whole mission with the Sedona Celtic Harvest Festival is to reach out to young people and music education in the schools and to make music more accessible, more fun, more friendly by relating it to history, by relating it more with the context within which it was created. You know?
Right, sure. There's a lot of inspiration to be had.
Yeah, there is. It makes it more fun, makes it more interesting. And if you just want funny songs, we've got lots of those too.
Oh, yes, I bet. Now, the next song that you're going to play us is a traditional Irish song.
Yeah, I thought I'd choose a song that's more traditional. It's a song by the Fury Brothers. The Fury Brothers had a lot of big folk hits on Irish radio in the 70s, and they've never been really heard outside of Ireland, so I thought it might be fun to play you a special request by Dorothy O'Brien, the head of the festival.
Sure.
She requested I play one of her favorite songs. So this is a song called Sweet 16 that went to number one in Ireland in the late 70s.
All right.
And one of the Fury Brothers that wrote this song was very good friends with a little Scottish group called the Humble Bums, which was Billy Connolly, the comedian, and Jerry Rafferty, very famous recording artists from Scotland. So this is an interesting song to pick.
It's going to be a good one. Well, thank you so much for being here. It's an honor
pleasure.
To have you on the show.
Can't wait to see you at the festival. I think you're doing a wonderful job, and I see great things for you.
Awesome. Thank you. And for you, too. Check out Carl Jones on Facebook, Carl with a K. Thank you guys so much for being with us on the Verde Valley Experience. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for having me. When first I saw the love light in your eyes, I thought the world had naught but joy for me. And even though we've drifted far apart, I never dreamed but what I dream of thee. And I love you as I never loved before, since first I saw you on the village green. Come to me ere my dreams of love are over. I love you as I loved you when you were sweet. When you were sweet last night, I dreamt I held your hand in mine. Once again you were my happy bride, and I kissed you as I did an old anxiety. The church we wander side by side, and I love you as I never loved before, since first I saw you on the village green. Come to me ere my dreams of love are over. I love you as I loved you when you were sweet, when you were sweet. 16.